Hello, and welcome to Movies with Max and Me. I'm Bailey. This is Max. He's playing with his new hedgehog. He's very, very excited about it. Yeah. He loves it. So today, I want to talk about another movie. We talk about Sleeping Beauty. This movie is a little different. I'm speaking of Bambi. Bambi is a movie that a lot of people kind of have an interesting relationship with. I feel like Bambi's one. I know. Deers. All the deers. Bambi's a movie I feel like that you've either... You either love it. Bambi's a movie that you either love or you just really, really hate. Personally, I love it. And today, I want to talk to you a little bit about why I do, in fact, love Bambi so darn much. So, Bambi was released in 1942. Now, they started work on Bambi actually way back in the beginning. It was supposed to be released before Pinocchio, which was the second movie that did get released. But it took more time than they thought, because Disney had this annoying habit of trying to make animals look realistic, which is fair. I think it worked out very well. But they weren't entirely happy with the finished product, so they bumped it back, and it's actually released later. So Bambi is referred to by a lot of people as a masterpiece by Disney, and I can see it. It's realistic. The animals look great. You can tell that they did some reference work to make it look good. It's one of the only Disney movies where there's no actual singing by the characters. They have a chorus, and I think that makes it flow a lot better into the story, if that makes sense. On Spotify, there used to be an interview with Nine Old Men talking about the creative process that they used with animating on those two old men, the Ollie Johnston and Frank Thomas, and they talked about kind of that and how that went, what their process was. A lot of that information can be seen on the DVD release, the Platinum Edition, because obviously I own the Platinum Edition. Probably also on the Blu-ray Diamond release as well. In addition to all of that, I also own the fully restored 55th year anniversary edition. There are no special features on this, but it is still pretty. The other interesting thing to look at is with the different boxes, there's not really much change. This is the first release, this is the second release. This is cuter. This is a bit more action-y, but there's still, because you can see the two deer fighting in the corner there, fighting in the background. It's not bad though. They're both fairly similar, but neither of them really have a lot of extra fluff. I think you have to be a specific type of nerd to look for Bambi-related fluff. So the animators, this was one of the first movies where the animators went on a lot of field trips. They went to zoos, they brought in animals to the studios, so they could kind of see how the animals moved. And there's a lot of things, they were trying to go for a realistic approach. The only problem with that, young me always noticed that during the storm scene, the trees aren't really moving enough, or they're not moving at all. And I was like, there's no way in a forest the trees aren't going to move. Disney. But that's okay. Also, a lot of people talk about the ice skating scene and how animals don't actually ice skate. That is true. They used human animators. They used human actors to kind of get that movement right. So I think that's kind of a cool detail. And it also kind of helped round out the Disney Animation Studios toolkit. So Snow White was kind of the groundbreaking one. Pinocchio kind of refined a lot of those techniques. Fantasia was very experimental. Dumbo was a nice, light and fluffy, though we'll talk about Dumbo, kind of returned to form, and then Bambi brought out that realistic aspect. It's also in the top 10 top 10 films in animation on Internet Movie Database. So, the weird thing about Bambi is that Bambi was actually based on a book by a guy named Felix Salten. He's Austrian. It was published in 1923. Now, I read Bambi a long time ago because I liked the movie and I wanted to know what the book was like. It was emotionally scarring. Bambi has this whole, like, I think I want to go off and live in the woods, but I also really love Feline. Do I want to go in the woods with my dad? Do I want to stay here? He's got these other friend deer. One of his friends is a cousin named Gobo, and Gobo lives with these people who give him head of a salt lake, and they take care of him, and he's like, I like my human. He goes back. because he sees a human and he gets shot, and it's kind of horrifying. Like, there's a lot of lot going on in the book that's different than what goes on in the movie. And the movie, let's not forget, is traumatizing enough. Honestly, looking back at Bambi, I watched it in my class, and I realized that Bambi dies, like, could have died, oh gosh, I want to say 6 times, let's see. He almost gets trampled to death when he's a little deer. Then there's the meadow where his mom dies. Then he almost starves to death during that winter before his mom dies. He has that fight with the other deer. He gets shot by the hunters. There's a blood spot on his leg. Then he has to outrun the forest fire after being shot. He gets chased by the dogs. So yeah, 6 times. Oh, and then he jumps down a waterfall. So seven times that Bambi could have died. And they didn't even put in natural predators. They just put in, like, people, other deer, and environment. Like, they didn't even add cougars. So this is kind of, it's a movie that's, it's a lot. It is a lot to take in when you're a kid. But it's also a lot of the time very, very sweet. It's mostly a story about growing up, and it's this little deer who grows up and tries to kind of figure out what his place in the world is, and what should he do. And it's really just kind of a nice story that does go real deep and kind of lets kids wrestle with some of those things in a safe place. Because if you're watching Bambi, you're probably watching with parents or older siblings, and you can say, oh my gosh, what is this? And also, no movie ever made me, like, Smokey the Bear was very influential when I was a kid, but Bambi was the movie that really reminded me, no polluting. And I grew up in the forest, and it was one of those movies that made me think, I share this space with lots of other critters. I need to be respectful of that. So that's pretty cool. That was Bambi. I have less to say about Bambi than Sleeping Beauty, mostly because Bambi is less... People liked Bambi, and Bambi was less of a risk. It took a long time, but it was less of a risk. It didn't, like, cost the studio a lot of money. I mean, it did, but not as much as Sleeping Beauty. It made back its money. People liked it. It wasn't viewed as, you know, a flop. All my information for this episode did, in fact, come from my book, A Journey Through Disney, My Look Back Through Disney Canon, available now on Amazon.com. So, from Max and I, thanks for joining us on Disney Movies with Max and me, and we will see you for the next one. Bye.